My father was a great student of the classics and history and philosophy. At the same time, he was a friend of nature, and this was equally true of my mother. Every weekend, we would go out and study nature in the spring. We looked for spring flowers. My father knew where there were some limestone quarries where one could find some interesting fossils. He learned there was a heron colony nearby, so we went to that one day. My mother knew all the mushrooms. So I had a very good all-around education in natural history. In fact, I can say that I was a naturalist from the time on that I could walk. And being a naturalist is very important. I can see this all the time in my studies in the history of biology. Darwin was a naturalist. In fact, he says so in his autobiography. I was born a naturalist, he said. His famous friend, T.H. Huxley, was not a naturalist. And it becomes very clear when you read Huxley's writings that whenever it really depended on true understanding of nature, Huxley didn't have it because he wasn't trained as a naturalist. And you find it even among more recent authors. For instance, the paleontologist Simpson, with whom I jointly taught a course at Harvard, and he was a very good friend of mine, I very often sort of noticed that there was something lacking in his understanding. And when I somewhat recently looked at his species definition, his so-called evolutionary species definition, I said to myself, if he were a naturalist or had been a naturalist, he couldn't have made that definition. And I went to his biography. Sure enough, I found that he had gone to college as an English literature major, and only in the senior class in college had he become interested in geology and eventually in paleontology. And he never had that feeling for species that a naturalist has.